welcome you here this morning. So good to see all of our friends and family and new people. Welcome to Aloha Chapel Hilo. I just wanted to, before we start the study, while some of the parents are still back there, I wanted to say thank you so much. Yesterday, I turned 40 years old, and man, you guys turned 40 years old. I feel like I'm 20. He's a little young. But yesterday was awesome because I got a lot of emails, calls, and just messages from you guys. So thanks, especially a lot of the students. You guys were so nice to Uncle yesterday, calling me and leaving me all those Facebook messages. That was awesome. So thank you again for all of your love and your birthday greetings. That was awesome. What I am going to do is for the next 7 days, I'm doing a video blog on the Facebook and YouTube at youtube.com/LoaChapel. I started it yesterday. Some of you guys have already seen it this morning because you guys came. But I'm doing a video blog for the first 7 days, for the first week of being 40. And what I'm doing is I'm just sharing with them some practical things and kind of some reflection on what God did in my life to this time and what I believe God's doing now and what God's going to do in the future. And so if you're on one of those things on your computer, go ahead and check it out. Well, we started a series 2 weeks ago. This is our third week. And we've been, the series is called How to Stay Strong in a Rough and Tough World. Okay, How to Stay Strong in a Rough and Tough World. If you have your Bible study notes, you can bring them out. And what I'm going to tell you to do, why I left it blank again this morning is because as we start teaching and developing these scriptures, God is going to speak something to you for you. And so, even though this is the title of the series, you might get something, God might speak something directly to you at the end of it, during the study. Just write that on the top, okay? The other section right there is for your notes. And then, obviously, there on the bottom is what thing will I apply or put into practice or change in my life? And that's the one thing that we really focus on here, because I think you can go to church and get a whole lot of information. A lot of people are sitting there and they're getting information. And the information is correct information. It's good information, especially if it's coming from the Bible. It's the right kind of information. But even more than just getting information, it's important that you and I apply the things that we're learning. And that's what we call the application, right? We put it into practice, or it becomes a little bit, you know, of our lives. And so many times we think like, oh man, I gotta go to church, and all coming to church is really good, or I gotta do this, and I got. But if you can focus on one thing a week, when you come, you know, just as you're driving, you're thinking, man, just go, man, God, what one thing? God might do 10 things in your life that morning. But just what one thing, you know, is going to change? What one thing am I going to take and apply into my life that day? And so, as we have been going, through this series, we said that the word strong, last week we said it meant power or might. Another word for strong is intense, enduring, or tough, if you remember that from last week. We also have been asking these three questions for the last 3 weeks, okay? And every week, we started the first week, and everybody, this is the first time they heard it. They're like, okay, this is going to, you know, last week is the second time, and then this week. And it's going to mean something to you a little bit different this morning because of what you went through this week, okay? And so the three questions are, the first is, what do you do when your world gets rough and tough? What do you do when your world gets rough and tough? You can write down the questions or basically write down the answer. You know, what do you do? The second question is, who do you turn to when everyone and everything is coming against you? Again, who do you turn to when everyone and everything is coming against you? We talked about that the other week. It seems like it's coming in from all different directions. It seems that all of these things are happening to our life, the people closest to us. Okay, what do you do when everyone and everything is coming against you? And then the third part here, the third question is, how do you handle the unexpected attacks of life? How do you handle the unexpected, and I even added that word last week, even the expected attacks of life? Okay, so those are the three questions that we've been asking every week to kind of, you know, prime things and then get things, you know, to kind of settle things in. But you got to ask yourself, how do you handle the unexpected attacks of life. Because all of us, right, every week, depending on what we're going through, we all answer these questions a little bit differently, right? And so this morning, we're going to go back to our original passage that we've been teaching out of, which is 1 Samuel chapter 30. We've been teaching out of that passage for the last 2 weeks. And this morning, we're going to continue on, read a few verses there, and kind of develop this thing called spiritual warfare, or doing spiritual battle, okay? Because a lot of people, I tell you this, when you start talking about spiritual warfare, or you start talking about how to be successful in spiritual battle, man, it's like having the key to Satan's strategies. And man, I'm telling you guys, the Word of God is crystal clear when it comes to what his strategies are, who he is, and what our position in victory is as children of God. And so we're going to consider God's Word this morning. We're going to look deep into God's Word and develop spiritual warfare together. And beyond, like I said, I don't want people, I'm saying that up front, so that as we go through it this morning, people don't get like, oh, remember we talked about the devil. We're going to talk about the devil because the Bible talks about the devil. It doesn't exclude him. From the very beginning, in Genesis chapter 3, all the way through the book of Revelation, it talks about this guy named the devil. So we're going to talk about him, not in the sense to kind of lift him up, but to be very clear about who he is. And so as we go through the Word this morning, nobody needs to be alarmed or, you know, who's the devil, you know, all of that stuff. We're going to go through God's Word, and God's Word is crystal clear as to who he is and what his position is today. And he's a defeated enemy. That's his position today. He is a defeated enemy. So we're going to go through God's Word together.